the medical supplies they need, to a life they deserve to live. That can take on a range of meanings. There's a global pandemic right now. Most people in that country don't have access to vaccines. That certainly is something we'd love to help with.
As you all know, the incredible freedom fighters of Cuba have risen up against their communist dictator masters. These people have destroyed that nation for nearly 70 years. The jackboot of communism has been upon their necks, and hopefully, God willing, they are throwing that yoke off right now. It is an incredible thing to see. Yet the Biden administration doesn't think so. The Biden administration is sitting there trying to tell you the lie that it's because of vaccines that they want to rebel against their government. This stuff is so insane. It's so weak beer from these absolute communists who run our government. I mean, it's just amazing. I mean, it really is incredible. Commies defending commies. That's exactly what this is. Jen Psaki today at the White House would not disavow communism and would not say, hey, communism doesn't work and it sucks and we should never have it anywhere in the world. Jen Psaki wouldn't do it. It's incredible. Watch her get asked again and again and again why this is happening in Cuba, and her hair turns as red as the hammer and sickle on the Soviet flag in response. Incredible stuff. Watch this.
And then on Cuba, you're talking today about how some of these protests are inspired by people exhausted with the government. Why is it that yesterday the State Department was saying that this was all happening out of concern about rising COVID cases?
Well, I would say first that the protests were just happening yesterday. We're still assessing what is motivating and, of course, and driving all of the individuals who came to the streets. But we know that when we say exhaustion, the manner by which the people of Cuba are governed, that can cover a range of issues, whether it's economic suppression, media suppression, lack of access to health and medical supplies, including vaccines. There are a range of reasons and voices we're hearing from people on the ground who are protesting.
So when these protesters are yelling freedom and enough, there are people within the administration who think they're saying freedom from rising COVID cases.
Again, I would say that when people are out there in the streets protesting and complaining about the lack of access to economic prosperity, to the medical supplies they need, to a life they deserve to live, that can take on a range of meanings. There's a global pandemic right now. Most people in that country don't have access to vaccines. That certainly is something we'd love to help with.